For somebody like me, it feels like it's really all just centered around
sex. I mean, I'll give
sex.
You an example. In my friend group, I'm the only polyamorous person, and I have the least sex out of all of my friends.
Yeah. But Gary, you seem like Jada was very, very understanding. Are you more like her grandma or more like Jada?
No, I would be more like Jada, honey. I mean, because in this day and time, honey, I mean, I feel that we should all just be who we are. Just, honey, it should be free love like back in the day. Didn't the hippies have free love or something like that?
Yes,
no,
Gary.
Did.
We can't do no free
they
love
did.
Back in the day. Back in the day, AIDS wasn't rampant and all this other COVID wasn't rampant. It can't be like it was free love. Like, no.
Right. I didn't sleep because I don't like nobody to touch me anyway. Now I got 3 boyfriends and 2 girlfriends.
Gotta buy a real big bed with Porsche sheets.
Oh, Lord. We don't make sheets for that size freak.
For me, it's a little much. I mean, I respect it, but it's like a little much. And I think on the long term, I don't know how that works, polyamory. I have friends who do it, and they've been doing it for years, so.
Sherry, who is the friend who's doing this? Can we know?
Don't you tell.
What's the dish tea? What's the dish tea on that?
When you in a polyamorous relationship, do you go, this is my boyfriend, my girlfriend, and my boyfriend? Like, how do you introduce
yourself? Yes, this is what you do. Yeah. This is my love village.
Hey, don't forget to hit us up on social media. We're on all these platforms at Dish Nation. We'll see you there.